table, they always want the same thing replicated, right? But 30 tables, this is the design, so I need 30, 30, 30, 30, 30. But whereas, why not mix it up? And maybe have two or three tables with two or three of these designs on one table. You know, it gives you so much more impact and changes the mood for the whole setup. Instead of having just 20 large arrangements and these tall urns, we have nests of arrangements throughout the event. It just changes things up a little bit more. But the impact of that, I believe, is much more lasting and more memorable. For instance, somebody going to this wedding will sit down and look and go, oh, the arrangements were beautiful. They incorporated feathers and antlers. They had beautiful candles in these burlap containers. Whereas the other 30-inch tall glass pedestal arrangement, oh, I don't know, they had this big glass thing in the middle of the table. And as a florist myself, I consider myself a florist, that's really disheartening to think that somebody spent all that money and all the guests in the room just thought, oh, they had these glass things in the middle of the table. Whereas with this, wow, how memorable would that be? And perhaps if they had a destination wedding in northern Michigan or a beautiful country club in a wooded setting like maybe at the Majestic or Walden Woods, not too far from here, this would be perfect for that outdoor setting kind of deal. I saw these just before we came on the stage. That's a beautiful container, full wire, looks like a chicken wire mesh container with the burlap. The burlap seems to be treated so it'll hold up a little bit more. By treated, it's waxed, okay? So if you put a plant in there and it gets wet, it won't stain the burlap. You'll be able to wash it out and use it, reuse it. Very different. But if somebody just, you know, not all of us have an unlimited budget. Maybe the bride just wants to put some rum plants on the table. Well, this would be a great item to upsell and convince her that there's a value to use this in that design, right? I would like a little bottle. Now, Swooters Oasis came up with that button line. It's been really hot. We've been selling a lot. So I saw the button on here and I was just kind of follow that trend, right? If you, once again, go to the internet, big buttons, and you see a lot of different cool designs with buttons. So just something to upsell and arrange for a wedding, or perhaps just for the shop. You know, I want to give something away, get some nice container like this. There's a nice giveaway. David used a standard cylinder base. He's added some bar to the bottom. Our very first display, I think, as you walk through the door, we have a number of different bar items. So instead of using gravel like he used in the other one, he's used a little bit of bar. He's taken some of the birch wrap, like a almost birch ribbon, and covered the bottom of the cylinder with it to give it a different look as we're moving forward. Hanging a little bit of roping. I think there's a couple more pieces of art up here, a couple of mechanics. You'll be able to see a little better when it's out on the table. Okay. David used a standard 6-inch loamy dish to put the arrangement in itself. So it sits right in the opening of that glass cylinder. That's a nice, inexpensive container. All the rest is a rental. And every time I pick this up, the birch paper shifts down a little bit, but it's alright. See how he's treated the bottom of the glass. Very simple, very quick and easy. David, I'm assuming you just use glue, right? The top hand glue, because it dries very quickly. So once you make your ribbon loops with that yarn type or lap ribbon, add a little bit of cattails and some birch branches. Local front flowers again, using the local flowers, I think that's a great idea. Carnations, you know, so many times we shy away from carnations. What color we want impact. It's really, you know, hydrangeas, roses, and carnations, they do the job. Now recently my mom had some tests done, and I sent arrangement to the house because she was feeling bad. Everything was fine. But I told the florist, I said, now when you do the arrangement, I want carnations in it. And I want something from this arrangement to last 2 weeks or more. You know, I'm not one of those snobs who says I'm not going to use carnations. Why? They last forever. And they have so many beautiful colors, the purples, the moon carn series, where you get that true lavender, true dark purple, hot pink, peach, great color. So don't each half here. See the difference in the size? You know, I don't want you to order that red maker and they get these small bears and be disappointed. So that's why I mentioned it. Big difference. Beautiful color. I still love this. I think they both have their place. Because the problem with that romance series is you don't get as many bears. So if you really want a lot of bears in a different look, I think you have to go with, you know, the standard Hypera and just cluster more pieces together. The chocolate glitter smile-up sleeves, David has taken, those are permanent, and he's added that to the bouquet as well. Tape, double-faced tape, and then wrap the burlap on it to get a texture, right? So two things, if you just took the bamboo pole and try to attach it to the driftwood, it'd shift and slide, right? So I used a double-faced tape and a burlap ribbon to give it something to grip onto. What I didn't pay attention to, because I was in a little bit of a hurry, is you know bamboo has sections. And each section, actually two of the bouquets that I made to go with this, on this one here, I just used three different roses. This is a Moana yellow rose, and this three of those in here. I used some of those peach finesse, and then used a few milk roses as well. So I used like nine roses and a few dry components. And then just to give it a little bit of more of an eclectic look, I added some of the giant beaded mega bead wire from Spinner's Oasis, as well as some copper brilliant. And this one here, you know, one of the things that always concerns me is price, right? So many times our customers are going to, you know, Sam's to buy flowers, just put bouquets together. But oftentimes, it doesn't necessarily take a lot of flowers. It just takes design and style, right? And if a bride sees this, the first thing out of her mouth is not going to be, well, I think I'll just go to Sam's and buy those flowers and put that together. Because even though it's a simple round arrangement, it's still a lot more to it than that, right? So I think it's a good idea when we're showing things, whether on our website, our literature, and we try to be a little bit more creative in style without getting too extravagant so brides understand your value and why they should come to you, the professional, to put it together. Oh yeah, one stem of lilies, which gave me two rows. Some butterscotch daisies are beautiful. We'll grab the bunch later and show you the new variety of butterscotch, which is a huge, beautiful cluster. And then just a little bit of yellow buttons here that we'll finish it off. Years ago, I'd gone to Europe. We were doing some buying in Holland and Germany. And I got to go to Gregor Hirsch's shop. Okay? I forget, I think it was in Amsterdam. Anyway, Gregor Hirsch did everything in structures, right? So I thought, I never really had done okay in the structure before. So I thought, what the heck, I might as well experiment with folks right here. So I did. I took an artificial manzanita branch, I cut it up and rewired it, so I have a base structure to hold from. It keeps it very light. Then I've added just a couple of feathers off to the side. And I thought, what says fall more than cattails, beautiful brown cattails? We have fresh ones out of California. Isn't that crazy? It's not, we were about 75 on the way home today and get cattails, but we ship them all the way from California. Personally, I don't want to get arrested if I stop on the side of the road and buy a bunch of them, but, you know. I added a little bit of painted green amaranthus to give it some movement. Another ironic thing is I know that the designers the other day asked, hey, I got 32 feet of ribbon out there, you guys better use ribbon. But I didn't use ribbon in anything. I used the hanging green amaranthus. I call it nature's ribbon anyway. Isn't that beautiful? Again, these are local sunflowers, sunflower bob, beautiful pincushion protea, mini gourds from Canada. So some local products, different types of things. I've added just a couple of purple Louisianas, the mariachi variety, which has a very heavy head, lots of petals. Okay. And then also tucked in there are some purple carnations, just for depth and texture. And a little blue thistle or Parentian added to it as well. Gives a beautiful tight wrap right away. Using white ranunculus, white lisianthus, garage pins. Very simple finish, but it makes for a very beautiful look. She's also taken some of the mega wire and created a collar that she's added to the back of it. Okay, so when you finish the back, so you can see the mechanics later on after the show, you can see how physically she put that together. Because it's beautiful the way it is. But to me, my first thought was, how'd you do that? So we left it open so purposely you can see that later and look at it. She did a great job. Thank you, Melissa. This is Melissa. She works at our health power department. She's here every day. She can answer any of your questions. Kim's also done this bouquet. I think the kale, the flowering kale, is a beautiful touch. I don't think ours is local. I think it's out of California. But you can tell your customer it's local. Actually, it might be foreign. I think it's Canadian. Yeah, it's Canadian. So you can tell people that it's local stuff. So I don't think that's local. Canada's like the U.S. it is, right? A little bit of the Dusty Miller sage. Beautiful roses. Do you know which variety you have? Avant-garde roses. Real important is, years ago, to get avant-garde roses, there was only one variety. I was back probably in the 70s when I started in retail, and that was sterling silk. Don probably remembers sterling silk.
Yeah.
But sterling silver roses, that was the only lavender you had. Today you have some lavender that runs a little bit more than blue lavender. You have lavender that runs to pink lavender. You have different shades of lavender roses. So again, I think it's very important when you're deciding which variety you want that you be very specific. And then you try websites, but oftentimes websites don't often give you what you need as far as coloration goes. This is a shameless plug, you probably see this coming. If you go to www.wordly.com, you'll see a flower gallery there that is one of the best flower galleries in the country. It was voted on by some different bloggers, and our flower gallery on our website is one of the best out there. So if you go to wordly.com and go to our flower gallery and search on roses, there's a beautiful selection of roses that have been accurately photographed to give you a very specific shading and color variety. So anyway, Kim has just taken a little bit of the from Green River to wrap the handle of that location. I did the one similar, I guess, as the Kim, that was kind of supersized. It added some blue salvia and some alien. I used that kale again. You can see the different, I've added some purple carnations into the mix, as well as purple Louisianas. So I've created quite a variety there. I call this my Michigan lavender bouquet. A lot of Michigan local grown products with the allium and the salvia, kale. Just a nice mix. I added just a few mini green hydrangeas. So many times if I'm doing hand ties, I just take two large hydrangeas and then mix the other colors.